tell me some of the countries you've coached fighters from. Argentina, US, Mexico.
We have Bochka.
Nicaragua, Ukraine.
He's from Armenia. We put up his Armenian flag. We put up his
Armenian flag. Oh, yeah. How do you do in the Olympics?
Ramla from Somalia. You know, we got people from all over the world, all walks of life.
That's what boxing's about.
All
right.
We put together.
That's
like
what
I always say, you know, we're in the hood. You know, we're in Southgate, we're in the hood. But I tell you, man, this is what I tell managers, fighters, coaches. I can't control what happens on outside on the street, but I sure can control what happens inside my gym. So as you can see, we have much of a camaraderie. You know, everybody gets along. People from all over the world. Good environment. Good healthy.
Good energy. That's for sure. But I'll tell you how I know I'm in the hood. Because every store I walk into in this block, they see me, they start talking to me boxing.
Oh, dude.
The Nicaragua guy around the corner.
Hey, that's because you're famous.
He's like, no, that's because they watch. He goes, the Nicaragua guy, you know, the grocery store? Uh-huh. He goes, Ellie, how much should I bet on this fight? He's always asking. He bets. Hey, Manny, he bets big money next door.
You're boxing community, man. I mean, you should come to the gym in the evening. It's packed with.
I will.
We cater to the community.
Kids, yeah.
So we have an after-school program, you know what I mean? And we got a lot of kids coming into the gym. And this is one of the only boxing gyms in the area. Really, there's nothing in the surrounding area. So we give kids an opportunity to, you know, come to the gym and train and work out and keep them off the streets, man. And then we got talent like Virgil, talent like Candy, and then, you know, Ramla, up-and-coming boxers that, you know, this kid, you know, Kristek and his sister, they live in South Central, man. So
wow, they come here.
So they don't got it easy. You know?
He's super talented. It's a sacrifice.
Great kids, good role models, you know what I'm saying? Trying to make a difference. You know what I mean?
By the way, shout out to the Fighter's Voice. Rich.
That's right. I'm going to be on the show tonight, man. What's up?
Oh, that's how you're giving him a shout out.
Send a shout out to my boys.
All right, stay tuned. Manny, where do people follow you?
Manuel.boxing, brother.
Okay, if someone's watching this, whether you're a coach or a parent, you've been there, you've made many champions, what advice do you have for someone who trains their kid?
Well, for someone who trains their kid or someone that, look, it's just, most important thing is to stay in school, get an education, and then obviously stay disciplined. You know what I mean? Put your work in. So there's no secret to success. Oh, hard work, brother. You know, just doing it every day in and day out. Showing up to the gym every day, putting in your road work, your conditioning work, boxing, school, homework. You know, listen to your parents. You know what I mean? Because parents are always right.
What's a good age to start? What's a good age? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12?
It's always a good age, you know what I mean? It's always a good age. It doesn't matter. You can start bringing your kids into the gym. I started bringing my son to the gym as soon as he was born, man. And he was in his mom's belly, you know, she was already coming to the gym, you know what I mean? So it's just something that some of the Mexican boxers are born with. You know, we have it in our blood, man, to fight. I mean, it's just, I don't know how else to put it.
It's in the DNA.
It's in our DNA, for sure.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned.
Like you said, we got fighters coming in from all over the world, you know. Amer and his sister,
the whole neighborhood is Nicaragua, by the way.
They're from Maywood, which is right down the street.
Yeah,
we got some Texas boys, you know. We got Hector coming from Texas, you know what I mean? But, hey, it's all good, man. We got love for each other. He's a Dodger fan now.
Yeah, you know. He has to tell you his Bitcoin story, but not for this moment.
Oh yeah, not for this
moment. Nah, but did you ever hear it?
No.
He had 9 Bitcoins.
Really?
No, could have.
Well.
Could have, shoulda.
And he could have peaked and sold. He would have been $500,000 richer. But instead, he did a Joe Murat. Hector, you know how to fight southpaw too?
Nah, I tried, but...
Not for you.
Not for me.
Do Do you like fighting southpaws? It don't matter. Anybody can get it. You're the can man. Hey, he's hitting hard right now. He could cry. You're sweating.
Yeah.
You used to not sweat when you worked with him.
Yeah, sweat time. Hot in
here. He's getting big. How old is he now?
17.
Wow. One more year. No more child support.
That's right.
He's going to turn pro soon or the Olympics or what do you want?
I'm having all my boxers take 1 year in college at least.
Okay.
And then...
That's very smart of you. What would you want? What would he take?
Me?
No, him. What do you think he's going to take? What's his major?
He wants to do kinesiology. Kinesiology.
Like to be a trainer?
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Recovery and all that stuff.
Smart. It's going to help him as a fighter.
Yeah.
I said Virgil should take pharmaceuticals because his nickname is NyQuil. He puts people asleep.
Yeah. NyQuil or NyQuil?
NyQuil.
NyQuil.
Night, night. Maybe the left is NyQuil, the night is, sorry, night is the right is NyQuil.
Benadryl and NyQuil.
How you feeling? Good? Tank or Ryan? Gervonta Davis or Ryan Garcia? Who? Who wins?
Ryan? He's been sparring Ryan.
Oh, you've been sparring Ryan?
Yes.
Oh. I didn't know that. Ellie Sekback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.